The group stages all come to this. The competition hangs in the balance for England and Pakistan. Both realistically need victory. The day began with one of the greatest rivalries in sport, India versus Pakistan. India made the first move of the morning, dismissing dangerous Hasnain in the third over. Pakistan had moved to 45 for 2 after the first power play when they kicked on, big shots coming from Shabazz. But when he nicked behind the over later and was swiftly followed by Tiwana, India were in the driving seat. Pakistan bats were making starts but weren't converting. India had kept the run rate low, and so Hamid saw the need for quick scoring and started hitting big. And despite some more wickets falling, Pakistan dominated the final few overs to post 150 for 7 for India to chase. A slow start for India quickly erupted as openers Wasim and Kunal began taking their fill off some poor Pakistan bowling. Wasim was the aggressor and after three consecutive sixes brought up a 27-ball 50. By the ninth over, India had their 100 without loss and looked set to cruise to victory and directly into the New Road final. Wasim got caught in search of another maximum, but Kunal's graceful innings passed 50 and India sauntered to victory inside 18 overs. They stay unbeaten through the group stage and it will take something special to beat them in the final. With Pakistan's loss in the morning, the only thing between England and finals day was victory against Bangladesh. Both sides hadn't got the results they'd have wanted in the tournament so far, and both had been looking to assert themselves with a fast start. England batted first and made a solid statement, losing only Thomas in the first power play for 48 runs. ...16-year-old Angus Brown stuck in for England, becoming the rock of the innings, but he was out caught for 45, although adamant it hadn't carried. England brought the 100 up in the 14th over, but the three wickets they'd lost had somewhat stunted their progress, and giving away more wasn't helping. Callum Flynn posted another good score, and England's effort ended 148 for 5, a solid knock, but certainly leaving the door open for Bangladesh. England would have been desperate for early wickets, and one couldn't have come sooner as Tyler bowled Imran first ball. And he had another in his next as England made a dream start. But Bangladesh knuckled down and played some shots off of tight England bowling. The halfway mark was reached 58 for 3. England weren't allowing batsmen to convert promising starts and were keeping Bangladesh under wraps, few runs and regular wickets. Things were clicking for the hosts in the field too, and all they needed to do was hold their nerve. Some big shots off some loose balls meant it came to the last over, Bangladesh 9 down with 12 required for victory. England hearts were pounding when the first of the over went for 4. But a catch in the deep sealed a vital victory. England through to finals day by the skin of their teeth.